sorry I'm a few minutes late. I always tell you guys, I am like a homespun, like real life workouts. So I'm having technical difficulties this morning, so I had to go. And by technical difficulties, I mean both my iPads died because I didn't charge them when I got home. And so I'm having to go off my desktop. And so sorry to my YouTube people, but it's just one of those things. I'm usually pretty good about remembering, not today. Okay, so I shared that. We are going to go ahead and get started and have some fun. This is my cardio weight workout, and I love it. We are going to get our blood pumping, maybe some sweat in our eyes. All that is fine.
What is that stripe? Do you guys see that stripe across the screen?
So strange. Anyway, so we're going to have a good time. What do you need to remember? The same thing you always need to remember. Your form needs to be awesome. And by awesome, put your elbows straight up in the air and stretch. By awesome, I mean everything's tight. You are in control. Everything is tight. I just realized I don't know where my exercise ball is. It's all fine. Okay. So I'm really excited about this. Let's get going. So what we're going to do is we'll do back and forth, back and forth. Legs and abs. I don't really think we need that for a while. Oh, we actually do right now. So the first one, no, we don't. Sorry. So we're going to do down, down, up, up. So I want you to get down, down, up, up. Down, down, up, up. Normally, I would be using 5 to 8. I have my trusty ones. Each exercise is 1 minute. Work your hardest. That is all I ever ask of you. So jump down. Keep your core tight. Shoulders back. You want to make sure your knees are behind your toes. Up, up. Down, down. Up, up. Down, down. Up, up. I'm going to have to stop and turn on my air. Down, down, up, up. If you don't want to do the jump at the bottom, you don't have to, but if you can do it, it's an added challenge. Come on, we got this. Keep going. We can do it. Do not quit. You take breaks when you need to. 3 to 4 seconds. 5 more seconds left. 2, 1, done. Oh my goodness. Kicking my butt. Already? Okay, let's turn this thing on. Woo! Still learning how to work everything in this house. For sure. Okay, the next one, get down on the ground. So we're not taking a lot of time between exercises. Say hello to Tom, everybody. He's here watching over our workouts. Okay, 1 minute, you're gonna lay flat, and you're gonna reach up and touch foot, hand to opposite foot. You can rest your head in between. I want you to squeeze your abs really tightly. You are not kicking your leg up, you are squeezing your abs to make it all happen. Got this. Come on. We can totally do this, right? Of course we can, because we don't quit on ourselves ever, 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 ever. It's just not in our vocabulary any longer. 3, 2, 1, done. Okay, up and at 'em. Next is going to do a half burpee. Okay? So what that means is it's not the full awfulness of a burpee. So I would like you to use dumbbells. In fact, I can use dumbbells for this. Let me just get the right ones. Okay, so what you're gonna do is put your dumbbells on the ground. You're gonna shoot back. You're gonna jump up. Okay, so you're not doing the jump at the top. And I made a mistake, I'm not using weights. Anything that twinges a little bit, I'm not doing. Because I am going to get this elbow fixed once and for all, okay? So let's go ahead and go. So you're standing up. I would like you to use 5 pound weights. If they're uncut, you should be able to put them down on the ground and have your hands wrapped around them. If you cannot do that, don't worry about it. No big deal. You can just put them down, do the jump back, then pick them back up. More seconds. Fight for what you want. You take those breaks when you need to. There is no shame ever in doing that. Done. Woo! Okay. What is our next exercise? We are going to do a 4-arm plank. Okay. So you're going to want to fold over your mat for a little extra padding. Your arms are at a 90 degree angle. Your entire body is straight. We're going to hold it. I can tell you that planks are phenomenal core exercises, and your abs are part of your core. So I'm always gonna love these. Okay, let's go. 1 minute. Everything is tight, your feet are together. Do not let your hips start to sink. Breathe in through your nose, out through your mouth. You are in control, you are strong. This is the way you continue to build strength, to build definition, to have better balance, all of that. Did you read about that woman who held a plank for 4 hours. She broke a world record. That just makes me feel sick to my stomach. There's nothing about that that makes me want to attempt that. I'm honestly really happy with my 20 to 30 minutes, 5 or 6 days a week. It's exactly what I need. 2-1 done. And, keeps me in good shape, keeps my energy levels high, keeps me sane. I don't like this top, it like cuts into my shoulders. Okay, I don't wear it that much and now I remember why. Okay, the next thing that we are doing, I don't have my ball. I don't know where it is. Kids play with it sometimes, then it just ends up somewhere else. Okay, so we're gonna do a leg up bicep curl. So I want you knee up, and we're gonna jump, and you're gonna go up and down. So I would like you to use 5 pound weights. If you're really new, use 3s. But you really have to squeeze that bicep, and then I want full extension when you come down. You have to squeeze your abs to, sorry, I have to change a setting on here. I don't know why it turns off so fast. Oh, because auto lock is on 30 seconds, that's why. Okay, so that this should make it better. All right, 1 minute. Squeeze those biceps, squeeze those abs. Keep going, I'm gonna turn my fan on. It is definitely, you can tell it's super muggy outside. Oh, feels good. Okay, keep going. Squeeze. I feel like it's really dark in here. Let me try these other lights and see if they go on. I don't know why. Oh, looks like I have a couple of lights out. That's the problem. Okay, so one more thing to add to the to-do list, and they're the ones right there, which is probably why I look a little dark. Squeeze. Full extension. Don't skimp on the extension. As you get tired, you're not going to want to do that because you have to get the weights back up. But it's really important. Good job. Okay. Next one. Okay. I do love working out. It's hard sometimes, but I really like it. Okay, so we are going to do a twist. I want you to hold one weight, twist from one side to the other. So you see that I'm back at an angle. That's what I want. Being back at that angle forces you to work harder. And that is what we are here for. So lean back. You might need to double up your pad or a little tailbone relief. Squeeze. You got this. Come on. I love the way this feels on my spine. Just feels nice to get that rotation in my trunk and keep those feet together. You're tight. Everything's tight. Everything's working together to keep your form good. When you need a break, you sit up 3 to 4 seconds, let the burn subside and get back in. But you always finish the minute. You do not quit on yourself ever, 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 ever. That is not happening anymore. You can break that habit, you really can. Like for me, learning Spanish, it is so hard. I'm not good at it. There are days that when I have my lessons, I'm like, I don't want to do it because I don't feel good at it. And it's hard to not feel good at something. But when I stop and stop being so critical of myself, I realize progress, just like with these workouts, progress is measured in small ways and you have to pay attention to them. You're not going to go from where you started to where you want to be in a month or 2 months. You have to keep going. And that's when you learn and grow. Okay. So the next one we're going to do is skaters. So we're going to jump from one side to the other. Okay. So I really, really encourage you to focus. Keep these core muscles in your mind's eye, because if you don't keep them tight, there's no way that you're going to keep your balance. It's just not going to happen. How are we doing here? Okay, so make sure everything is out of the way that you could even possibly trip on, because you'll be wobbling a little bit. It just happens. I'm going to move that, fold that up, and let's do it. So you see, I don't have a ton of room here, and that's okay. You don't need a lot of room. You just need it to be clear so that you don't knock into anything or step on a weight or step on your dog or your kid. So when you jump to one foot, you really have to squeeze those muscles, because that's going to stop your motion. I'm using my 1 pounds. I would like you to use 5s, even 8s, if you're a little bit farther along. Woo, you're going to feel this if you did legs with me yesterday, but it hurts so good. If you lose your balance, that's okay. Just regroup and keep going. And when you have to take a break, you take it. You're going to notice towards the end, you start to lose your balance more. 3, 2, 1, done. Oh my gosh. Woo! Have a little bit of water, small sips. Okay, I'm just checking. Time. How are we doing? All right, we're good. We are good. The next one we're doing. Okay, we're going to do a straight leg sit up with a dumbbell. These are hard. Do not get down on yourself. You might want to secure your feet under your couch. Your hands are overhead. You have to squeeze your abs. Come over. All right. So we're going to do that for 1 minute. This is going to burn like crazy. Are you going to quit? No. Are you going to hold your breath? No. You're going to persevere. You are going to squeeze to get that up and over. I'm using a 5 pound weight. Normally I'd probably use an 8 because I would hold it with both hands. This 5 pound I'm mainly holding with my left. The physical therapist gave me exercises for my elbow, and I have to ice it 5 more seconds each day for 9 minutes, which hurts like crazy. But when you keep hitting it, and then hit it again, and then hit it again, you know, you kind of mess it up. So I just am trying to be good. Take it easy, listen to my body. Okay, we did a version of these yesterday and we're gonna do them again. You know what, I wish I had an 8. Let me go get an 8, I'll be right back. So you'll notice I'm testing out all these different places in my new house to work out. Living room, kitchen, outside. I like them all for different reasons. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we are gonna open and you're gonna pulse. So I want you to go, so this is your full range of motion. The pulse is half of the motion from the middle to the top. I want you to squeeze, I want you to push yourself. I want you to be working really, really, really hard. Okay, if you are doing this, and we're doing a minute on each side, and you're not burning, put that weight down and pick up a heavier one. Keep your feet together, very important. The 8 is perfect for me. Keep those abs tight. Do not let your body rotate back. You squeeze those abs. You keep yourself tight. All that's moving is that upper leg. Oh my goodness. Oh, you can do it. Take those breaks when you need to. But again, if that burn is not intense right now in your glutes, you better put that weight down and pick up something heavier and make it burn. That is why you're here. That is how we get results. Come on. We have 5 more seconds. Fight for it. 3, 2, 1, done. hit it a little bit, it helps. The heel of your hand, just hit that glute muscle. Woo! Belly. Okay. That feels, that's what they mean when they say, hurts so good. Okay, so rest your head in your hand. And remember to keep that upper body straight. Do not open up. All the power is coming from your glutes. If you are fighting saddlebags, this is a phenomenal, phenomenal exercise for that. Come on, let's go 5 more seconds. You might have one side that is a little bit stronger than the other. For me, it's usually my left. My left is usually a little bit stronger, and I have a little bit better balance on my left, even though my right leg is dominant. So figure that one out. All right, how are we doing? How's everybody doing? Okay, the next one we're gonna do is a hammock. And this is a squeeze hammock. Okay, so you're gonna lay like a hammock and I want you to squeeze and down, squeeze and down. If you need to support your head, cross your arms behind your back. We are gonna do this for 1 minute. It's hard as all get out, so take your time, do your best, but fight, fight, fight. Do not quit. Take those 3 to 4 second breaks when you need to. Squeeze. You don't let your shoulders and feet touch the ground. You take those breaks when you need to. Squeeze. Don't hold your breath. Ugh. Oh my gosh, the burn is so intense. 10 seconds. Ugh. Oh, we're done. Wow. That one's hard. Okay. Next. Oh goodness, what are we doing next? Oh. Okay. Next, we are doing my 3-step in. I love this exercise. So, normally I would use 5 pound, excuse me, 5 pound dumbbells. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So you squeeze those shoulders, squeeze those abs, work those legs, kick your own butt. That is what we're here for, okay? Got to keep those abs tight. You're going to squeeze them. They're going to help you get those knees up. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. You can always hold heavier weights and not do the rows. It's up to you. We got this. Come on. those breaks when you need to, 3 to 4 seconds. You can do it. Promise, promise, promise. I have total faith in you. 5 more seconds. Have faith in yourself. You're so much stronger than you think you are. That I know for certain. But we let this negative talk get in our heads. And especially, I notice with people who never played sports, they sort of think, I'm not athletic. I'm not strong. I've never been good at that stuff. Push that away. This has nothing to do with that. Doesn't matter whether you played sports in high school, whether you were ever an athlete or a dancer or whatever. Does not matter. What matters is right now, you pick up those weights, you fight for yourself, and you work the hardest you can work. You're not trying to do exactly what I'm doing or a friend is doing. You are working on yourself, you are pushing yourself, and you know when you're pushing yourself and when you're taking it easy, and taking it easy is not going to get you where you want to be. That much I can tell you. Okay. The next one that we are going to do, we are going to do a high, low, high, low. I'm putting that down immediately. I'm going to hold my 2 pounds, so high, low. You have got to squeeze. Really important. What I like about this one is we're working our abs and our legs. Okay, so we'll do 45 seconds on one side. You don't have to touch the ground completely, but get as close as you can. So I want you high up. You're gonna rotate down, squeeze those abs the entire time. So you're gonna be up on the ball of this foot when you're reaching here. You're gonna be on the ball of this foot when you reach down. I would like you to use a 5 to 8 pound weight, please. If you're further along, you can use a 10, even a 12. When you come down, you keep that knee behind your toe and you stay tight. Switch. Squeeze those abs. You have got this. Take a break if you need to. If you are sucking wind right now, you can also stop. Put both your hands on your knees. Breathe in through your nose, out through your mouth, and that will help get your, calm your breath. Get your heart rate down. Keep going. Do not quit. We are fighting to finish no matter what. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. Done. How are we doing on time? Oh my gosh, we are rolling. Rolling through this. Okay. I do not have the proper height thing to do what I want to do, which is a little annoying. Grab this UPS box. If you have something a little higher than this, use it. But I'm also a big fan of use what you have. These are the furniture covers for my new outdoor furniture. So what I want you to do is tap, tap, tap. And while you're tapping, pump those arms. I would like you to use 2s, 3s, or 5s. Weights. If you can do the 5s, do them. If you want to go heavier than that, you can just keep your hands down by your sides, but have the weights for added resistance. Okay, let's do this and do it well. Okay, so I want you moving at a good pace. Whatever it is, it needs to be secure. Thank you. 10 more seconds. Fight to the finish. Do not quit. Finish in a minute. If you can. 3, 2, 1. Done. Oh my gosh, and that's our alarm. Which means we're done. Which means you kicked ass. Okay, shot. Sorry. Oh my gosh. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Pull that wrist. You'll feel it. Triceps, lats down into your obliques. Oh my gosh. Lunge to one side. Keep that knee behind your toe. And you will feel this in your glutes and in your inner thigh. And oh my gosh, it feels so, so good. Now straighten. You can pull on your calves, your ankles, your shoes, and get a really good stretch in your hamstrings and your glutes. Then I want you to sit, put your forearms on the inside of your knees and push out. That was fun. Then put your shoe in your hand. I want your knee to go down into the back, and then you'll really feel a great stretch in your quads. The goal here is not to look like a bodybuilder. The goal here is not, here's so many women, well, I don't want to get bulky. You have to be so intentional to get bulky. You just do. Pull your knee into your chest. It's a very intentional way of lifting, a very intentional way of eating. That is not what we are about. I never lift any heavier than 20s, and that's only when I do legs. I generally stick in the 5 to 15 pound range, although right now my elbow is, you know, slowing me down a little bit, but I'm still working out and still persevering. So all I would tell you is you will get to find, you will be amazed. If you watch your eating, you will be amazed at the changes you see in your body, definition, weight loss, strength, balance, the whole nine yards, not to mention all the other benefits, the emotional, mental, spiritual, just everything, everything. So give it a try, commit, don't come in and out. You can do that, of course, that's your total prerogative. Try to commit. Just do it wherever you are. You can do these workouts wherever you are. I'm going on the road for almost a month. I'm going to be here and there and everywhere, and I just make it work wherever I am. I'm taking my 1 pound weights, and that's it. And I'm going to stay in shape, and I'm going to work hard because I can. And that's what's great about these workouts. So anyway, tomorrow, probably total body, just to make it all work together, since definitely lower body sore and upper body from Guns for Girls. So I will see you tomorrow morning. It'll be at 6 a.m. tomorrow. Okay, have a great day. Bye.